So hi guys, my name is Nachiketa. Welcome back to another video. In this video, I'm gonna explain everything you need to know about bias, variance and its trade-off in machine learning. This is a very fundamental concept and again a very popular topic for data science interviews. So many questions can be asked from this, like what's exactly the problem of bias, what's the problem of variance, how do you solve the problem of a high bias, a high variance, and what exactly is this trade-off all about. So I'm going to answer all these questions in depth, so make sure you watch this video till the end. And if you do like this video, subscribe to this channel and like this video if you want me to put out more content like this. So what you're seeing on the screen right now is everything you need to know about bias, variance, trade-off. But as usual, let's start from scratch. So I'm giving you a problem over here, a sample problem. In this problem, basically on x-axis, you have the number of workers, number of construction workers, let's say, who are building a house. And on this plot is basically shown how the number of workers is related to the number of days required to build a house. So you can see that as the number of workers are increasing, let's say you are using 5 workers or 10 workers, the number of days required to build a particular house is coming down. And after a particular point, it stops reducing, right? For example, if you have just have to build one house and you're using 1 lakh workers, the time required is not going to change much, right? Because there's only so much work a worker can do. So this is the relationship. And let's say you're a construction company, right? And you want to build a machine learning model to understand this relationship so that you can just give your model an input. Let's say that I'm going to be using 8 workers. What is the estimated time to require to build this house? So let's say we're building a machine learning model like that. So when you're building a model, right, basically the bias variance concept is important to understand to know about all the problems that can come up. So we'll start with the problem of bias. So let's say your machine learning model took a straight line and tried to fit that line to this data, right? This basically, this yellow line that you're seeing is what the model is predicting. So basically you can take any point on the x-axis and see the corresponding y coordinate to make a prediction. As you can see that this is not a good model, right? Because it did not learn much about the data. It's simply a straight line and we wanted something like a curve, probably a quadratic equation. So this is not a good model and this will not give you a good accuracy on the training data, right? This data that you're seeing, let's say this is the training data that you're training the model on. So you're gonna get a very bad training accuracy, and this is the problem of high bias. High bias basically means that your model is gonna give you a bad performance on the training data because it failed to understand the pattern in your data. And this is because the model that we're using is not flexible enough, right? It's a rigid straight line. It cannot bend and fit according to the data. So this is a bad model. And as a machine learning practitioner, you should know what is the solution to that. You should also be aware of what is a good solution and what is a bad solution. Let me tell you what a bad solution over here is. A bad solution for the problem of high bias would be to increase the data. For example, in this case, you can see that no matter how much data you increase, right, your model is not going to perform well because it's simply a straight line. No matter how you turn and twist the line, it will never be flexible enough to understand the data, right? I'm showing you different orientation of the line to show you that no matter how you twist the line, it is not going to understand the data. So if you simply increase the train data, let's say you take 10,000 samples, that will be of no use because the model is simply not flexible enough. This is the problem of high bias in machine learning. And to summarize, this is what I've written over here. This is a problem of high bias. It does bad performance on the training data because the model is not flexible enough. It cannot understand the patterns. And what's the solution? Adding more data is not a solution. What a good solution could be is to increase the model complexity, right? If you're using a 2-degree equation, a 2-degree polynomial, maybe a 3-degree polynomial could help. Or you can try different models, maybe support vector machines, maybe decision trees, or maybe even go on to neural networks if the model has to be very complex. This is how you solve the problem of high bias. So let's move on to the variance problem now. So I showed you one problem that can come up, right? Let's look at another kind of problem that might come up when you are building a model. Okay, so this model that I've shown over here is what a high variance problem could look like. So as you can see, this model has drawn a very complex curve to fit the data, right? And this will give you 100% accuracy on the training data, right? Because it has passed exactly through all of these points. But you can get an idea that this model is very complex and is not gonna generalize well, right? Meaning that it performed well on the training data, but there are extremely high chances that once you try it on some testing data or some random data, this model is not gonna perform well. This is the problem of high variance. High variance problem is basically said when you have great performance on the training data, but you have a bad performance on random, unseen or testing data, right? And this is called as high variance because the performance really depends on the data set. On different kinds of data set, the model can give very different performance, right? Because this model, this complex curve, is only gonna perform really well for this particular data set. And in machine learning, you always want to build a generalized model. So this is the problem of high variance. And what is the solution? Two broad solutions. One is adding more data, right? If you add 10,000 data, right, 10,000 data points over here, it is very likely that this complex curve is not gonna fit that as well. That's why it's gonna try to change the model and try to build a more generalized model. That is one solution. Second solution is regularization. Regularization is a technique that we use to prevent overfitting, and it basically penalizes the model for becoming extremely complex. I've made a detailed video on what regularization techniques are, L1, L2, lasso, ridge regression. So watch that video if you want this in more detail. But these two are the solution. So you should be very aware about this, right? If your problem is of high variance, then you wouldn't want to make the model more complex, like we did in the bias problem, right? You just want to add more data, you want to prevent overfitting. And similarly, you should be aware of what you can do to solve the problem of high bias. These two things are very important to understand, so keep this in mind. So this is the bias variance trade-off that I was talking about. So you've understood so far that high bias is bad, high variance is bad. What you want to do is you want a low bias and a low variance. So but what normally happens is when you try to reduce the bias, the variance tends to increase, and as you decrease the variance, the bias tends to increase. So this is the trade-off where you want to reach a balance where the bias and variance both are as low as possible, right? If you try to increase one, the other is going to decrease, and this is what the trade-off is all about, right? And you can understand why this happens. If you're decreasing the bias, you're basically meaning that you're increasing the performance on testing data. You're making the model perform better on training data. If you try to do it too much, you might end up overfitting, which basically results in high variance. And similarly, if you have a high variance problem and if you want to reduce it, you're basically making the model more generalized. And if you do it too much, it might end up become so generalized that it does not understand any patterns at all, like this linear regression model. So this is the trade-off, and that is why you should be exactly aware of how to solve the bias problem, how to solve the variance problem, and then reach at a balance where both variance and bias are kept as low as possible. So that was it for this video. I hope you liked this video. This is the most detailed explanation that I could have given in this short amount of time. But if you did like it, do like this video and subscribe to this channel, and see you in the next video.